Hi everyone, in this clip we are going to look at working with standard virtual switches in the vSphere environment. To start off with my host ESXi1, going to select configure and virtual switches in the networking area. We can see that we currently have one switch, which is vSwitch0. This is the one that's created automatically when we install ESXi. There are two networks attached. One is the management network. The second one is the VM network, which has virtual machines attached to it. We can see there's one VM. I'll expand that out, and we can see that it is the one and only virtual machine that's on this host. We can also see that there is a physical uplink, which is VMNIC0. We're going to create a new virtual switch that we're going to use for production for virtual machines. Going to click on New Virtual Switch, which will start our wizard. Specify that it's a virtual machine port group. Click on Next. I'm going to attach the port group to a new standard switch. I want an uplink. Click on the Add an Uplink. VMNIC1 is the one that I want. And I can apply a name, which is going to be production. There will be no VLAN associated specifically. And I can finish that task. I now have vSwitch1, which I can select and see that there are no virtual machines. Here's VMNIC1, which is my uplink. I go over to my first virtual machine. I can see at this point that it has an IP address, which is on the VM network. I'm going to edit the settings of this virtual machine and change it so that it's connected to my new production network. Pick the dropdown for network adapter, change to production. Say OK, and we'll go and see what that effect is going to have on our VM. I'll log into the virtual machine. And I'm going to release and renew the dynamic IP address. And notice now that this IP address is on a different network than what it was before. We were on the 192.168.158 network. Now we're on the 172.16.1 network. If I go back over to vCenter and refresh the display for my VM, we'll see that the IP address is now updated. That's a wrap for this particular lab dealing with virtual switches. Hopefully this was helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.